Lee went from a thunderstorm to a Category 5 in just a few days. Just how unprecedented is that?
Alicia, to put that into perspective, a 35-mile-per-hour increase in wind speed within 24 hours is considered rapid intensification. This storm saw an increase of 85-mile-per-hour winds in 24 hours. That is unbelievable. Now, with the warmer ocean waters, for every degree of warming, the wind speed magnitude goes up by 5%. And it's not like a Category 5 hurricane is 5 times stronger than a Category 1 storm. No, the damage potential goes up 429 times with a Category 5 storm compared with a Category 1. So with the climate crisis, we don't know if the number of hurricanes will be going up, but we do know, Alicia, that the intensity will be going up. And that is what is the major concern when these storms interact with land, especially. Well,
and just to underline that, I mean, we are in an El Nino year, which you are the meteorologist, so you will tell me if I've got this right. My understanding is it means it's usually a less active hurricane season. That doesn't seem to be what we're seeing here, though, right?
Now, with the Idalia, that's pretty typical. That is the part of the Gulf of Mexico or the part of the Atlantic basin that sees hurricane development during an El Nino year. But you are spot on with this. The development, the area of development is what is so concerning with this storm. Now, when you look at the ocean water temperatures, typically between April and July, the average temperature of the oceans goes down because the southern hemisphere is more filled with water than the northern hemisphere. And what that means is they're in winter, we're in summer. There's less water up here. But instead, Alicia, the temperatures have been going up. So that's been kind of the counter. The anomaly with our warmer than average ocean water temperatures kind of counteracting the impacts of El Nino, which would typically see a slower, quieter Atlantic hurricane season.
I want you to talk to us about the track of Lee, because we're seeing some encouraging signs. It may stay away from the U.S. coast. Is that what you're seeing, too?
Yes, and we hope that this trough, this area of low pressure across the Great Lakes, will sweep the storm out to sea. But that doesn't mean that there won't be battering surf. And that is a concern, because with erosion and rising sea level, that's a big problem. And as sea level goes up, it's not just because of the melting land ice in the north, you know, in Greenland and in Antarctica. When the warm ocean waters continue to warm and expands, that also contributes to rising sea level. So that erosion potential is still extreme, even if the storm stays out to sea. And one more point, the coral that's been damaged off of Florida, for example, that's a natural barrier to protect the coastline. So it's more than just the coral being damaged. It can have major impacts to the land.